All right. Got everything. Got the helmet I want. Got the gloves I want. Got the sleeves I want. Shoes. Think I'm ready for the Super Bowl, bro. Let's go. Save changes. Get comfortable here. Alright. Alright, let's do this.
Madden Football is the home of the Super Bowl, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Buccaneers.
Why isn't my white sleeves there, bro? What the fuck? God, this game glitches so much on my uniform. Whatever. Who cares? It's not what's important.
As it'll be the AFC champion New England Patriots taking on the champions from the NFC, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
So here are the Patriots now backed up a bit to start their first drive.
Okay. Holy crap.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 5-yard line. Shaquille Barrett in on the tackle.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. Second down, here's Barkley again. Oh, good move.
Okay. We at least got the first down.
Some breathing room. He gave it to him. 11 yards and a first down. The one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they're in sync, as we're seeing so far,
Jonathan Abram picks it. Well, they're gonna fucking score now. Okay. They're gonna get the first touchdown. Yeah.
The start that he envisioned in the Super Bowl, that has to be for certain. Through the interception on his opening drive, and now they'll start again here, first and 10. They begin with a run by Barkley.
I hate runs that start all the way back there. No, fuck you, coach. I'm not listening to you, because you're
waiting for him up the middle. But give him credit, he tried barreling through anyway. They're fortunate to get a yard out of that one.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Throwing is Mannion. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
Here's Mannion. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete.
Good shit.
And they have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's how you shake off the interception you threw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike, and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one. The man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now, meanwhile, a pass. pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
Okay,
third down conversion, 33 yards.
Yep, I agree. I agree with this. Let's see if we can make something happen here. Good shit. Go.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
They came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and showed that they can run the football.
Well, we got a first down, so that's all that matters. Let's go. Come on. Got nowhere.
Interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now.
Touchdown, motherfucker.
Patriots. DK Metcalf from 4 yards out. And the Patriots are an extra point away from tying this Super Bowl at 7. Bouncing back nicely from the bad opening drive where he threw the interception. Drive number 2 leads him. Their quarterback leading this offense back out. He had the interception on the opening drive, but bounced back to throw a touchdown last time out. And he'll look to build on that as they start first and 10. And he'll manage to pick up about 4 at second down.
Okay.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Off the play fake.
Oh,
the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Open man is Kendrick Bourne.
Go. Yes!
And all the way in.
Kiss my ass. Motherfucker.
Super Bowl. Great corner route there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field.
Out is their quarterback.
Tie game, and now.
To take over once more.
Now we have a chance. We have a chance to take the lead here. Let's do this.
Drive out on the ground. 41 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Looking to throw. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. He's taken down and able to slip across the 35. He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season. And that's his first catch of the Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down. They'll try the right side here, Barkley, and that play.
You see, the running game is not
losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36.
Running game is not good.
That's going to bring up second and 11.
Two things to watch. First is strength and being able to break out of that initial contact. But at his size, once you slow his momentum, it's hard for him to get it started again.
I want to try this. I do like this play.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11.
Ah.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I would say it would probably be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half because they're definitely different wavelengths. But I also don't advocate waiting that long. Next series, before you get out there, hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A big one there on third down. They hit for 30 yards. 2 minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl.
All right, we get it. Come on.
I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
Catch is made by Metcalf. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this
what,
game,
wait, what the fuck did I pick? Oh, shit. I didn't even know I picked that shit, bro.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
Ah.
To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Here now is second and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
Oh no! Yes! Oh, I got lucky. I did not mean to throw it to him, but I'm thankful I did. Oh, I got lucky there, bro.
Second quarter and already his second touchdown reception.
Absolutely the definition of a difference maker here in this first half.
All right. I'm glad I tossed it to him because that's not who I was aiming for. But at least I took the lead. That's all that matters. Let's go.
Their quarterback in this offense heading back out to the field. He had the touchdown. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And a dangerous throw there, incomplete. He threw that into coverage. It was nearly intercepted.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. This time they stay on the ground. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as it comes with 22. For the Patriots taking over to start quarter number three. And through one half at least, this Super Bowl has been everything it was cracked up to be. All tied. What's your key for them, Charles, in the second half?
Simplicity, partner. Because in the Super Bowl, with the extra time at halftime, I think some staffs get caught up in trying to design too many things. It's all tied up. They have to remember what they did to get here. Put that back into play here in the second half, and I think they'll be all right.
19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball. They leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. 11 yards there, just like last play.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start.
I disagree with this, but I'll go for it.
Sloppy tackling.
And it's knocked away and incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. He'll look to throw. A quick throw, knocked away and incomplete.
Partner, for once in my life, I'll be succinct. In a one possession game, every single stop like that could be a difference maker.
Open man is Metcalf.
Yes.
And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 19. A sizable 16-yard chunk there. The drive continues.
Ah.
And that nearly intercepted. The free safety rolling into position almost had it, but it's second down. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
That's a big force incompletion there to bring up third and long. And this defense can still salvage a little momentum. That forces them to kick a field goal. Because just a few plays ago, they looked like they were headed toward
touchdown.
That's what I'm talking about, bruh.
His second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Patriots have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
Okay. It's my second Super Bowl. Just scored a touchdown. I'm in the lead.
Here
hopefully
again
I can keep
it. Of this offense leading his crew back out there now. Really solid effort for him right now.
Okay. Come on, I gotta win my second Super Bowl. Come on. Come on.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. This complete to Henry over the middle. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
Yeah, that didn't go anywhere.
At the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Third quarter, Super Bowl 58. Here's a second and 10 now. Now a pass here caught by Henry. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
Not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can guess situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And he will have the Patriots first down as they're able to convert by plenty there on third and one. Back to throw now on first down. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Henry. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. And we're back in the Super Bowl. Time to decide who gets to hoist that Lombardi Trophy as we begin the fourth and final quarter of action. A first down carry for Barkley. Down at the 25.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but
every time he looks up,
he barely missed that shit, dude.
Eighth play of the drive, fourth coming, and they need 8 yards on third down.
No!
Sure, he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
Yeah, my coach ain't gonna let me go for it. No, I understand. Still plenty of time on the clock. Take the extra point. I get it.
New England's offense set to go. And the tension ratcheting up all around. A one-score game. Fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is what you folks came for. Every play with the potential to win or lose a title as they look to drain some time off this clock. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting
come
it
on.
Down.
Come on. Come on.
From the 27, Mannion.
Oh, no.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's
double coverage, bro. Why is the coach suggesting shit? I swear to God, if they score, I'm going to be so mad at the coach. I'm going to be so mad if they score. You motherfucker. I'm not listening to you anymore, coach. Fuck you. You can kiss my ass. Punk bitch. You don't know what the fuck you're doing, coach.
He'll look to throw. To Henry. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner. Watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
He'll get this to his tight end. It's Johnny.
There we go. There we go. There we go. What's good, bruh? What's good, bruh? Fuck you, man.
What a game this has been, and what a drive that was, Charles, to take the lead here late in the fourth quarter.
That's a job well done by everyone.
Now the defense just needs to stop them here. 54 seconds on the clock.
Might be a little bit too much time left. Enough on the clock for a final last-ditch effort to try and steal this.
They just need to stop them. That's all they need to do, bro. Don't let them score. Just don't let them score. That's all you got to do. Oh.
New England trying to get a place on offense.
Where are we? Oh my God, you got to be fucking kidding me.
Now a first throw here in overtime. Open man here, the tight end Henry. Oh, what a juke into space. A huge play there in overtime. 46 yards.
Well, if you're a fan of offensive football, this game is for you because this one's been much more like a tennis match than a football game. Back and forth, back and forth. And there's another example right there of another big play in the passing game.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. Open down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Another first down there as this one goes for 25. With that last completion, CD's now over 400 yards passing in the game. And quite a few of those have come via some pretty big strikes downfield. Certainly not afraid to challenge the secondary, and it's been successful.
I like your observation there, partner, because I agree. This is a group more than capable of torching a secondary any week, as evidenced by their combined stat line here. And in the time we have remaining, one shot me off to see them take another deep shot.
Saquon Barkley running right, and here he'll get it down to the 7. 71 yards rushing for him now to this point. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
The last run got 6. Now 2nd and 4. They'll drop the throw. And it's caught.
Yes!
They win the Super Bowl.
Let's fucking go, bruh. Y'all can't handle me, bruh. Let's go. Second fucking Super Bowl title. Let's go. Cuz. Motherfucker. Mannion. Remember my name, bitch. I'm sorry for all the cussing, bruh. But I get hyped when it comes to this. I did it, bro. I won my 2nd championship. Let's go. Let's go. I won my 2nd championship in Madden, bro. Let's go. Second time I'm holding the Lombardi trophy. I'm so happy, man.